Good afternoon, data fans, and a welcome back to San Jose, California. We are here at Nvidia GTC, rocking through our very exclusive interviews in the Equinix booth. Cannot wait to introduce this next guest, Vinay from Zetaris. You are having a moment right now. Welcome to the show.
Absolutely, Savannah. Thank you so much for having me.
It's been a bit of a commute. You came over from Aussie, right?
Yeah, it's only 24 hours, no issue. Yeah.
Casual.
Had a nice sleep, and here we are.
So, I want to talk, first of all, you've started Zetaris 13 years ago.
Yeah.
Long journey, I can imagine, between now and then. Quite a culmination of things happening for you right now. Talk to us about some of the excitement.
Yeah, look, starting with the excitement, obviously, we've landed with, I think, the game changer for data management for enterprises. And we'll talk a lot about that, I'm sure, with our modern lakehouse for AI.
Yeah.
But the big excitement is having Robert Hedjevic join us and become our executive director for strategy. That's amazing. And why we're doing that, basically, we've built the best product, best data platform, best lakehouse. We want to get the best leadership around it. So that's happening. And then growth
in
America.
Hold on, though. I want to stop there just for a second. A friend of yours met him in the school drop-off line, correct?
Well, it was actually one of our shareholders met him, and who's works is a banker for one of the big global banks. And basically, Robert has been on the hunt for what's the next big thing in AI.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and he's super competent, super smart in cybersecurity, but also AI. And he basically knew that data is the biggest problem.
Right.
You know, getting data right, getting enterprise data in a form that AI can consume it. So he's been looking for a company that's on the data side of AI. And it was school drop-off, you're right. Dropping the kids off, he asked this question, and our name popped up. It was unbelievable. Yeah.
What was it like for you when you got the phone call that your name had popped up in that moment?
I actually thought it was a prank. So I said, no way, go. I basically hung up on, it was one of our directors saying, hey, you know, the Shark Tank guy, Robert. I said, oh, well, he's the best, right? He's the guy I'm always watching. Well, he wants to have dinner with us. And I said, yeah, sure, we'll see you later, right?
Yeah,
and
cool,
I
just, see you at dinner.
Yeah, see you, no worries. But yeah, I went to dinner, still very skeptical, thinking, no way, can't be. You know, in Sydney, we've got a shark. We've got a lot of sharks in Sydney, but not from the Shark Tank, right? So. And he turned up and, wonderful dinner, got to know him, and amazing person, very down to earth, and fell in love with our idea and the concept and the way we're bringing AI to the data, not having to move data to AI, right? He just loved that concept, and, well, we've announced it now and he's on the team, so we're super happy.
Yeah. Well, and it's clear that you've got a really compelling offering. Other folks playing in the data space, obviously. But, you know, when we think about a modern lakehouse for AI, talk to me about how Zetaris is so differentiated.
Yeah. So when we started off, the reason I started the company was I was at these big data platform companies like Teradata, Green Plum. I worked at HP, NCR, and so on and so forth. And the common theme was that customers would restart their data project every 2 to 3 years. So basically, their requirement got bigger and bigger and couldn't fit the current industry platform capabilities. And I asked myself and a little think tank the question, what's going on? Why is it, you know, every few years, you know, the customers are back in the market? And the same thing's happening with the current data platforms, what we call the legacy data platforms, you know, cloud data and even in the data center. Customers are continually looking for the next big thing. And so we started building out this data platform that would automate the data engineering, that would actually not need to move data to a central location and basically be able to deal with data in place. So we actually send the query to the data, or we send AI to where the data is to solve the business question. We call that the modern lakehouse for AI. So yeah, 13 years ago, we had this huge vision of changing the way data was managed in the enterprise. Took us a long time. We landed on it about 3 years ago in terms of a full solution. And today, we believe we're revolutionizing large companies by joining their data in place, layering over the current data layer, and in real time bringing data together, in real time solving for data quality. And then, you know, extreme automation, I call it, you know, where our competitors need armies of engineers, need all of this tooling and kit to make it work. We're using AI to automate all the way from connecting to data, transforming it, creating the view for AI or BI, and delivering the value.
And it's that real-time experience that makes the magic of AI real.
Absolutely. Well, I think it's more than magic. I think for the high-value use cases of AI, you need real-time access.
Right. Like,
think of a hospital trying to use AI for triage assessment or triage co-pilot. You can't have the data even 10 minutes old.
No.
It needs to be the data now. So our modern lakehouse for AI is a real-time lakehouse connected to data wherever it is, whether it's on the edge, whether it's in the data center in the cloud. We are location agnostic, and that makes a powerful solution.
Yeah. I can see why Robert is so excited.
Oh, he loves it, yeah. And coming from his cybersecurity pedigree, he understood that meeting the requirement at 100%, you know, with security, it's not 99%, 95%. Meeting the solution requirement 100% is the game changer, is how you break industries and break in. And we believe we've met 100% of the AI requirement for data in the enterprise.
I love that. Who doesn't want a perfect score? 100% is the way to do it. Talk to me a little bit about the role of partners and players like Equinix and working with them and what that's meant for you.
Vital for us. So, you know, the ecosystem is what makes the whole thing work. It's 1 + 1 = 10 when you actually bring the best of breed solutions to the customer, right? Mm-hmm. And so, particularly with AI, you can't have anything other than bulletproof hosting of your capabilities, bulletproof, you know, infrastructure behind the software layer. And I was talking to someone about this, the difference between BI and AI. So our legacy competitors grew up in the BI world where, you know, you could take overnight to load your data. You could even take an hour to be current. If your reports didn't turn up, did it really matter? The bank wouldn't stop if the dashboards weren't ready. But in the AI phase, it's absolutely critical because AI is your business. So you need to have bulletproof, high availability data centers, infrastructure behind anything you're doing with AI. And that's why we're partnering with Equinix, we're partnering with the likes of Hitachi, Cisco. We've attracted some of the big players very quickly to this whole idea of taking AI to the data and bringing down the costs. You know, the inferencing moment is so much quicker. So partners are critical to our model. And in fact, we have a partner sales team. So we don't sell direct, we sell through our partners.
Yeah. Well, that's convenient. That helps keep you lean.
Absolutely, helps us scale. So through our partner ecosystem, we're launching with 44,000 sellers.
Which
is just phenomenal, right?
That's
with Cisco, Hitachi, Equinix coming together to bring this modern lakehouse for AI in an AI-enabled data center like Equinix, yeah.
We had a touching human moment as we were getting started.
Yes.
You and I are both dyslexic.
Absolutely, both
Shout
dyslexic.
Out to our neuro-spicy friends.
Do it, yeah. Don't let it stop you. It's a superpower, I say. Yeah.
So talk to me a little bit about why you think it's a superpower and how that superpower has helped you build this company.
Well, there's a few things. So one of my sons is dyslexic as well, and I do say to him it's a superpower from my experience. The first thing is to really understand technology, you've got to go deep, and to go deep, you've got to go slow. So it makes me read slow, right? And I've always read slow, but the overall time to deep understanding is much quicker than my peers, some of my peers. So that ability to really slow yourself down and to understand and not just quickly read, that's a huge advantage. The other thing, as I was saying to you, it forces you to build relationships, right?
Totally.
Because you want to know what's going on if something flashes up in front of you really quickly. And nothing better than looking at someone saying, hey, what was that on the board, you know? And that's how I grew up at school. By being close to my peers in terms of understanding some of the written text. So I have a textual advantage with my dyslexia. So asking someone, what's that on the board, right?
Help me build those curiosity gets you a long way, too.
Absolutely.
It's the relationships, it's the curiosity.
What about yourself? How did you?
It's the openness.
Yeah.
Ooh, I think for me, it's always been... Thank you for asking me a question. I think it's always been... I can see the forest through the trees.
Yeah.
The more of the big picture I can see, it's very easy for me to then navigate what a larger strategy should be versus worrying about
those
little tiny details.
The thing with me, it's actually the reverse. for me is pattern recognition.
Like, yeah.
I find I'm seeing patterns that others miss. Mm-hmm. And as I was saying to you, I used to actually be the guy on the team that would look at broken code and find the problem really quickly. Because I think something to do with that advantage of being dyslexic,
right? Pattern matching
right?
is definitely our thing. I think that's why I see it big. You see it small together. I mean, you know, next time you're starting a company, call me up.
Let's get together. Yeah.
Get together.
We'll call it D squared.
Yes. Oh my God. And we'll hire your son.
Yeah, yeah.
I have one final question for you. We're at a really interesting time, and since you mentioned your children, I know that kids are a big part of how you ended up with Robert, which is very exciting. What do you hope our AI revolution that we're currently amidst, and all of your hard work, quite frankly, does for your family and for your for your kids' generation?
I'm super optimistic. I think AI makes us better. It really does. Mm-hmm. And you know, humanity always works out. We're a tool-based being, right? We look for the best tools. We always work out how to use things for our advantage in the end, right? And there may be, you know, ebbs and flows in terms of, is this going to be something that's bad for us or good for us? But ultimately, it's going to augment how they do things. It's going to speed up time to value for them and time to learning. In the use cases that we have at Zetaris, so we're working with hospital groups creating AI nursing assistants. We're working with banks creating AI mortgage brokers. Property groups, AI property assessors, all of those use cases are making the humans better and giving back time to humans. So in the hospital example, the nurse now has time, more time for caring and doesn't worry about the admin stuff that they didn't go to college to learn, right? They went to learn how to care.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm really optimistic. I think it's going to be an amazing world they'll live in. Yeah.
You know, I agree with you. I can't wait to help shape it, help watch it, and more importantly, to help see what you all do to make that possible. Vinay, thank you so much for taking the time.
Yeah,
this has been a joy.
I really enjoyed it. Thank you so much.
Yes, me too. And thank all of you for tuning in, especially to our neurodiverse friends who are hopefully feeling as inspired as I am after this fantastic conversation. We're here at NVIDIA GTC in San Jose, California. My name's Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.